Oh, hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. So my sweet friend Alexis recently gave me this really cute thumbnail dart frog. And with getting a new frog, that means building a new vivarium. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you how I went from this blank canvas to this piece of art. My name's Ryan, and you're watching Mighty Morphin Reptiles. Let's roll the tape. For my blank canvas, I'll be using a zoom-in naturalistic terrarium. Let's get it. I begin by flipping the enclosure on its backside. I use great stuff foam to make my walls. I start with the backside, and then I repeat the process on the left and right side, but I make my walls arched over. And I just visualize that I'm frosting a cake because I'm a fat boy at heart, guys. I let it cure out overnight, and this is how it turned out. Then I used a knife to carve the smooth surfaces of the foam because I needed to be porous to apply my media for the next step. Now, what kind of vivarium would it be if it didn't have any wood in it? I'm gonna be using ghost wood here, and I place it in here because I'm gonna try to make a tree trunk. Oh yeah, I think it looks pretty rad now. Definitely has that tree trunk root vibe to it. And just to make sure it holds in place, I apply a little bit more expanding foam. Then I grab some plastic food wrap and I wrap all my branches up just like a donut you would see at the gas station, as this will protect my branches from applying the media to the walls, because it'd be a real shame to ruin that pretty wood. Wood. And for my media that I'm going to apply to the wall, I'll be using Dry Lock Extreme, which is just a waterproofer, and I'll be using black liquid coloring with it. I mix it together to get the consistency of color that I desire of dark gray. I then just apply it to the wall, use a paintbrush, and just channel my inner Bob Ross. I then use washed play sand and sprinkle it all over the dry lock before it cures out, because I don't like the look of it by itself, and the sand will just add a lot more naturalistic texture to it. And I totally believe that the friction of it will help the frog be able to climb up a lot more. And this is how it turned out, and it's just so nice, but I could even do it a lot better. And I think it would look really good if there was like some brown along it, just to help make it look a little more dirty, and then have some black into it and throughout the cracks, and this should add a lot of definition to the wall. And I'm gonna achieve this look by using black and brown acrylic paint. Then I sprinkle some more sand on top of the black shadowing so it blends in. And this is how the background came out, and it just looks awesome. I mean, look at that sandy texture to it, the brown blemishes in to give that dirt look, and the black shadowing just totally defines the cracks and crevices, and just looks awesome. I then grab a spray bottle and mist down the walls to give it a good cleaning to get all the extra debris off. Then for my drainage layer, I just use liquid clay pebbles. I get it up to about 1.5 inches thick, and then I just smooth it all out. Then for my substrate barrier, I just use window mesh screen. Then I add in my homemade terrarium substrate that consists of orchid bark, organic potting soil, and sphagnum moss. And I'll leave a video link in the description on how I made this. Then I push the soil back towards the wall to give it a slope. This will give it a depth of field look. Then I lay down a layer of wet sphagnum moss, as this will provide moisture for my ground covering plant coming up. All right, let's get to planting. This plant right here is called rainbow moss, and it's so beautiful. Look at the blues and greens on it, and throughout time it'll gain reds too. I just grab some strands of it, cut it, and then just place it on my sphagnum moss, and the roots will just grow into the sphagnum moss over time. Isn't that just so lovely looking up close? I promise you, it's so much better in person. Then I'll be using this lovely pilea. Just look at the silvers along the leaves. It's so amazing. It's also called the aluminum plant. And I'll be using this as a background plant right here, and I'll be placing two of them back here. and look at the way it just contrasts with the background over there. It just looks so good, and from above, I just love how it pops out of the shadows like that. And this is called Begonia Rex, and I just love the silver and the red little heart-shaped leaves. They're so cute. They're small right now, but they'll grow taller. I propagated these myself. And I placed them right here along the left side of the wall, and I thought these would be a really good plant to use to just give it a little bit of color, just contrast everything. Then I thought it'd be a really good idea to have like moss growing throughout the cracks over here along each wall, a little bit on the tree, and it will just look really awesome. I mean, what kind of vivarium doesn't have moss? And to achieve this, I'm going to be placing moist sphagnum moss all along throughout the vivarium, then I'm going to be placing Java moss on top of it. The sphagnum moss will keep it moist, and I just thread it to the branches, and then when I put the moss on top of the sphagnum moss, I'm going to be pinning it. And it's Java moss, by the way. And I think it looks so good right now, but over time, it'll look amazing. And what kind of dart frog vivarium doesn't have a bromeliad in it? This is called Fireball, and I love the red onto it. I'm gonna be placing right here in the back right corner, and it does grow a little bigger than this, and the little dart frog would love to cup into it and just look so cute. Then I add my leaf litter, and I'll be using oak leaves, and this will just totally complement the vivarium. Then I had an idea. This is called Pilea depressa. This is from my other dart frog tank. I use it as a ground covering plant, and I had a great idea that I'm gonna actually be using this as a shingling plant in my new build right now. I'm just gonna be placing some wet sphagnum moss here, pin it down with some flora wire, and I'll grab some more clippings and place it in the moss too. And this will look really awesome over time. And now you're probably thinking to yourself, what about that hideous side right here? How are you gonna cover it up? Don't worry, it's totally easy, and I got you, my dude. And I'm gonna be using black poster board that I got at Walmart for like a dollar. Then I cut it to the shape of my foam walls. Then I set it on the side of the glass and then just use some tape. And then this is where you hit that like and subscribe button. Then I take some measurements and cut a piece of glass to fit. And if you guys want to learn how to cut glass, I'll leave a video link in the description down below. Then I left an inch of the lid open for some ventilation. Then I use a turkey baster to transfer my springtails over to the vivarium. I do this method a few times. And for those of you that don't know, springtails are really good at eating the algae, mold, fungus, and they just make a really good cleanup crew. But combined together with isopods, which I'll be using dwarf isopods in this vivarium, the dwarf isopods will help break down the waste and the organic waste too, so it's just an amazing combination. And for my last touch, I'll be adding a magnolia seed pod, and I just love the pinecone look of it. And I'm gonna be placing it right here under the tree trunk, and this will just kind of blend it all in. And I like to present to you my work of art. All right, let's put them in now. Now let's talk about the occupant for this vivarium. This is the thumbnail dart frog my friend Alexis gave to me, and it's so cute and small. It's literally called a thumbnail because it's literally the size of your thumbnail. I love the orange along its back, how it kind of got the black spots going and that green along its legs. It's so freaking adorable. I love it. It's like literally probably one of the smallest frogs in the world, and it's gonna look so good in the vivarium. And that's how I set up this lovely vivarium, and I'm so happy with the way it turned out. And I wanna talk about it now, like the setup and how the plants are gonna grow. So we'll start off with the plants. So for the ground covering plant, the rainbow moss, once it grows out fully more, it'll get this like reddish color. And as you can see from my other poison dart frog tank, look at that red. Isn't that so cool? That will give it a lot more color throughout time as it matures. And the Begonia Rex over here, this will actually grow up to like about 4 to 5 inches tall, and it'll get kind of bushy. It'll get a little too big for this vivarium, but that's totally okay because I actually really love like propagating the plants, trimming them up. It's a way for me to get like intimacy with the vivarium. That's one thing I really love about these tanks. And for the pilea in the back, that'll also get up to about a foot tall and can get a little bushy, but I'm gonna be totally trimming that up too because I want to sell plants eventually. And let's talk about the moss. So the moss will take a little bit to get established on the walls. I don't really expect it to spread everywhere since I don't really have much sphagnum moss to keep it that moist. But for maintenance, I'm just gonna be misting it twice a day, once in the morning and once in the late afternoon. And it should just get a little bit stringy and hang down. And for the pilea, that's kind of what I'm most excited excited for to grow out, as it'll grow straight down and just get like this viney look, and it should just like drape over. And I feel like with the pilea draping over behind the bromeliad, behind the tree trunk, it'll just add a lot of contrast. It'll help like that tree trunk actually pop out with all the other plants. It'll be really cool, and I'm excited for that. And I put it right here because I thought it'd be really good, as this is my station for where I can play on my iPad and just create designs and stuff, because eventually I'll be launching my own merch. So I'm super excited for that. And for the actual LED lighting, I can't remember what brand it is. It doesn't have its name on top of it. I got it with like some nano like aquarium cube a while back. But usually even cheap aquarium LED lights can grow out your plants as long as it's rated at 6,500 Kelvin. So that should totally work just fine for me. And if you guys got some value or fun watching this video, then please hit and smash that like and subscribe button. My name's Ryan, and you're watching Mighty Morphin Reptiles.